And this is Super Meat Boy. Widely regarded as one of the hardest platformers of all time. Now I did this entire like first world took me about 49 minutes to complete in total, including the boss. And yeah, it was a little bit the same of one of the hardest platformers of all time. Because the first world of anything has never taken me over almost an hour to just go through, not even like completely running through it. And this is including the tutorial level that you've been seeing. Right, so Super Meat Boy. There's not really much here to say. Everything you see right now is basically it. You platform, you jump, you can wall jump. So it's like having a wall jump on steroids almost, because if you hold the ZR button, you can do a long wall jump and a long jump, and you run faster. Also, yes, that bunny did run into the dam, which my dad. Evil bunny. It's a funny form, oh, this is an old weapon, but well, this is the one. Monty Python! And the Hunger Temple of the Holy Grail. It's a rabbit from that. Oh, well, this is an old weapon. Yeah. So. Apart from the art style, I can't really say much about this game. It's a fun platformer, very difficult. So yeah, I do like the art style. Well, you can see that right here, I do like it. Very chibi kind of style. I might as well explain why this was uploaded yesterday. And it was almost not even to be uploaded today. And that is because yesterday I went to the dentist, as I told you, but the night before my tooth kept me up pretty much all night. Again, for the second night in a row. And at that point, at that night I had 3 hours sleep, 3 or 4 hours sleep, and altogether those 2 days about 7 hours sleep. And it wasn't until last night when I actually got a decent night's sleep. So I was really muddy. Like, I was in pain and I had barely any sleep. Like, I would, if you were just come, if I say some off chance I was outside and how everyone might be somebody who watches my videos and has seen one of the videos where I have my face in it, somehow managed to recognize me and came up to me, I was crazy all day long. I would have still given them a death stare because I was just in that kind of mood. I just wanted the world to turn. And a little bit better. I don't want the world to turn. Still a big rouse here. But, yeah, what are you going to do about it? And I really didn't want to play this game when I was, when my, pretty much everything that I, you know, was just thinking about my sort of existence, something that I didn't want to play it and then have, then release a review of it. It's like, I hate this game, it fucking sucks, it's a pain in those platforms. I don't know if it's a pain in those platforms. But this is the first one that actually got me to die a few times. And I didn't need to want that to like paint my first experience. Like, I was so like unhappy that I'm just tired. I couldn't even be bothered to play Stardew Valley level. Because if you know, Stardew Valley right now is one of my favourite games to just sit down and play with nice, relaxing, and I just didn't want to play it or any other games as well, and Yeah, if I had forced myself to play this yesterday, yeah, I would not have been very happy. And as long as I'm and as long as I get good night's leads, I think we'll be playing back to normal. But if something doesn't go ahead and it should, you'll know why. It's because I didn't have a good night's leads before, and the medicine will kick in and I'll be able to get a decent night's sleep every night. And the closer I have to help you be able to drop the last few wounds and do what that power is supposed to be. But even now, I'm still a bit tired. So I'm going from the top right now. This, like I said, I've only been calling the narration of this for about 6 minutes. And there, I started to put a bit into this here. Yeah, we've been looking at some cool gameplay. This game, I did quite enjoy it. Like, it was all, again, when I was talking about dark in this. The Ender's Nigh. That's it. When I did a review on the Ender's Nigh, which even in that video I did compare it to this and the course on here. I said that one of the reasons why I enjoy it is because it's a challenge. You're failing not because of some shitty controls or something like in getting over it, Surgeon Simulator, so on and so on. You're actually failing because it's your skill, you fail because you're bad at the game. And that, you know, makes me more determined to just keep on going until I finish it. And honestly, if next time I take a break from Stardew Valley, the Ender's Nigh, Super Meat Boy, and maybe the Mega Man X Legend Collection will be the games that I'll just pull from the dark kindness. But yeah, all of these games will be wrestling for all my attention over not only Pokemon Let's Go, which I may be getting into like the competitive or wrestling to see how it develops and if it's really kind of interesting to get competitive Let's Go. So that's going to be a whole thing that I don't even know how you get competitive for Pokemon IV wise. But yeah. And then there's also going to be Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, which I'll be doing live streams of regularly because I love playing Smash Bros. I can't talk about it, but I love playing it. But yeah. This is. There's just one more thing I want to say before I hit. Because I don't want to just like ramble on. Like, when I do commentary on videos, I want like what I'm saying to be more interesting or even as interesting as what's going on the screen, because in my opinion it needs to be if you want your audience to split their concentration between what you're saying and what's going on in the game. Which is where I differ from this by how we think or I'm just gonna say this. The best feature of this game, and to be honest, one of the things that dying's not too bad, is at the end, which we've already seen a few times, it shows all your attempts, all the different approaches and everything. And when you like died a good few times, it is fun to just like watch just like 50 meat for you. Go on and die. This one I'm actually a little bit proud of, actually. I was that close to making it on my first try. Anyway, I'll see you guys in the next video. Hopefully I get a good night's sleep. And I'll see you guys when I'm not too tired.